what I've noticed is looking around your garden is you've moved in to a rental recently.
Yep.
What have you done to get this kind of growth?
Ian, I reckon probably three things, yeah? Firstly, there was quite a lot of hard work. Secondly, there was rain. And obviously bits and pieces of this areas of the garden, there's quite good soil. And we also did introduce some good wormage and compost as well.
There's a lot of fruit trees.
Yeah,
you've thrown them in.
Are you thinking about the whole rental thing? Like, why do you put fruit trees in? Because it's a rental?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
That's a classic question. I mean, and usually I answer that by saying, what else am I going to do on planet Earth, right? I mean, you have to either you spend your money going down to the shop and, I don't know, buying Coca-Cola or something, or you spend, you know, $30 on a fruit tree that's going to be there and it's actually going to give you some satisfaction by watching it grow as well. And you only have to do it once, right? Maybe every 15 years you'd probably outlay that much money. So yeah, to spend a few $100 on fruit trees isn't really much, particularly when it's a place that you're going to be inhabiting for some time and you like to encourage, you know, growth and seeing nice things in your house, you know.
The philosophy with our garden was that we focused mainly on the front because we wanted to meet people. And so it happens that we also met people through the garden tour, but watering out in the evening, we, you know, said hi to people, struck up conversations, struck up friendships. So the garden for us, not only to keep us away from shopping at the supermarket, was actually a social, cultural experience to integrate ourselves into Armidale and also give our daughter something to do as well. So, yeah.
So she knows where food comes from as well, yeah. Right? I mean, to grow up with a child and who knows that, you know, food doesn't necessarily just come from a basket or something in a shopping centre. It actually comes from the ground and she's seen us till it herself, you know. I think it's a really beautiful thing, you know. And yeah, connecting with people, and people obviously know us now. We're the freaks in the front yard with the floppy hats. with a cute baby. Things in our top pocket, man.
Thanks, guys. That was brilliant.
Thanks, Ian.